Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys. If you have a BMW 6 or 7 series BMW and you need to guys remove or replace your alternator, stay with us guys and we'll explain how to do that. We'll explain about common mistakes that can cost you thousands of dollars, so make sure you stay until the end. And we will also explain how an alternator that looks okay and charge your battery, actually when you turn the car off, it will kill your battery. So we'll explain that as well. Now, we'll guys demonstrate on a 6-cylinder N52 gasoline engine that can be found in BMW 6, 7 series in the rest of the world. It's offered in Europe, in Russia, it's offered in Asia and Africa as well. You can find guys, okay, you can find that 6-cylinder engine installed in 6 and 7 series BMW. Now, if you have an 8-cylinder engine, some of them are water-cooled alternators, but not all of them. If you have the regular alternator, the procedure will be very close and the concept will be almost the same. So, let me explain now, guys. If you need to buy new alternator parts, tools, anything like that, we'll share, guys, the links in the description of the video below for your convenience and you can see where we get all the tools and parts from. Number two, guys, every single car we get at the shop, we make at least 200 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you guys as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Let me show you guys specifically what we have here. Specifically, this is N52 gasoline engine, as I said. This is the alternator. Your alternator is driven by the serpentine belt. So, I recommend, guys, when you remove the belt, because you need to remove the belt to remove the alternator, inspect the belt and replace it if you need to. Inspect your pulleys if they're noisy or have play. Replace them or grease them. We have a video that explains that. So we'll release the belt and first we'll remove the serpentine belt. Now before we continue, let me just tell you one quick thing, guys. Check this channel out, Auto Repair Guys. This is our main channel and we have helped more than 75 million people. We have information that can save you thousands of dollars on car repairs. And on car repairs, on anything guys related to your car, we upload different videos, anything from mechanic, electrical, to bodywork as well. So, next, okay, the alternator. Okay, let's discuss that now guys. What we need to do, we need to disconnect the wire here that actually sends the signal for the voltage and how much it's charging. And before we continue after that guys, okay, we will need to disconnect our car battery. We have one wire right here. This is the charging wire that goes to the car battery. If you do not disconnect your car battery, you will have current directly coming from the car battery to this 12 volt wire. And if you touch it with a tool or anything, or the wire itself to the casing of the alternator, bolt, anything where it's ground, you will see sparks flying. You can actually damage your engine computer, electrical system, modules, and that could be very expensive and hard to fix. Another thing, most of you guys do not know, but on modern cars, it really matters, guys, okay, which battery terminal you disconnect first, positive or negative. Because if you don't do it the right way, if you don't disconnect the right one and then reconnect the right one first, you can cause damage to the electrical system and computers in your car. We did that in the past, cost us $2,000. So, I'll put a link to a video that explains all that in the description of the video below. Check it out, guys. Now, we have our car battery disconnected. We'll go ahead and remove the wire now, the charging wire. Most of the times, you will notice it's with a 13mm socket. Perfect, came out. Grab the wire itself, pull it out. Next guys, we're just going to put the nut there so we don't lose it. After that, okay, what we're going to do, we have actually four bolts that we need to remove. 1, 2, 3, 4. These bolts are recommended actually to replace them every time, okay, you remove them. We're going to use a reverse torque socket. We'll put the link to the tool in the description of the video below. Check it out. On the last bolt, guys, make sure that the alternator doesn't drop. What you will need to do, you actually need to hold the alternator really good because it's heavy and it will drop. Perfect. Okay. This one is still, one of them is still holding a little bit. Okay. Okay, and that's the alternator, guys. That's how you remove it. So putting it together practically is in reverse order. You took it apart. If you want to know how an alternator that charges your battery can actually cause damage to your battery and discharge it when you do not drive the car, it could be because of the diodes. We have a video that explains all that and how to conduct that test as well. I will put the link in the description of the video below. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.